There is new evidence providing yet another link between the Saudi crown prince and the brutal murder of Washington Post writer Jamal Khashoggi. And the US intelligence community is expected to soon release a long-awaited report with new details about those responsible. CNN's Alex Marquardt has details.
Multiple sources are telling me that the report from the Director of National Intelligence is expected as early as Thursday. We've been waiting a long time for this unclassified report. It was actually passed into law in 2018, but the Trump administration chose to ignore that. It's declassified. It's going to be released by the Office of Director of National Intelligence, which is required to lay out what the intelligence community has found out about what Saudi officials knew and what they did. Now, after Khashoggi's murder in 2018, the CIA assessed with high confidence that the Crown Prince, Mohammed bin Salman, himself ordered the brutal killing. The prince denies it. And we are learning about yet another link between MBS, as he's known, and the murder of Jamal Khashoggi in Istanbul. We've obtained documents from a Canadian court case which revealed that the two private jets that carried the Saudi Arabian hit team were operated by a company that the Crown Prince had taken control of less than a year before the murder. He had ordered that this aviation company be transferred into the country's investment fund, which MBS controls. I did speak with a lawyer for Khashoggi's former fiance, who calls the revelation of these documents extremely important. He says that it shows a direct line to MBS killing Jamal Khashoggi. We did ask Saudi officials for a response, and we did not get one. They are likely worried about that intelligence report that is coming and what it will say about the Crown Prince, whether this declassified intelligence report holds a smoking gun, proving that MBS ordered the killing is what everyone is looking out for. Meanwhile, President Joe Biden says he has read the unclassified report. He hasn't offered any details, just saying that he will be speaking with the Saudi King Salman soon, which is notable because he still hasn't done that after more than a month in office.
New today, CNN has learned the release of a long-anticipated report into the killing of Washington Post columnist and Saudi journalist Jamal Khashoggi has been delayed. The report from the Director of National Intelligence will wait now until President Biden speaks with the King of Saudi Arabia, King Salman. That is according to three officials who are familiar with the matter. Khashoggi was critical of the King's son, Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman, and his policies. And in October of 2018, here in this video, Khashoggi was seen entering the Saudi consulate in Istanbul. A Saudi hit team had arrived just a few hours ahead of him, and Khashoggi was killed minutes after entering that compound. The CIA later concluded that the Crown Prince personally ordered the journalist's murder. He denies this. But now new CNN reporting is shedding light on just how closely tied the Crown Prince was to the killing. Documents from a Canadian court case revealed that two private jets used by Saudi assassins were operated by a company that the Crown Prince had taken control of less than a year before the murder. I'm joined now by Agnes Calamar. She is the UN Special Rapporteur on Extrajudicial Summary or Arbitrary Executions. She was the lead investigator on the first independent report on the murder of Jamal Khashoggi. Agnes, thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
You put out your report on the killing in June 2019. You laid out the detailed evidence that suggests Saudi officials at the highest level plan to carry out this murder and hide it from the international community. What are you looking for in this report coming from the U.S.? This delayed report, but, you know, hopefully we'll have it soon.
I'm expecting clear evidence of the role played by Mohammed bin Salman in the killing of Jamal Khashoggi. I'm expecting evidence proving that he ordered the killing, that he was fully aware of what was happening, and that he gave it its full endorsement.
So you're expecting that he was fully aware, that we'll learn he was fully aware, that he endorsed it? Are you expecting that this report will say he directed it?
Yes, that's what I am expecting, indeed. Mm-hmm.
And so you called in your investigation, in your report, you called for a follow-up investigation to determine individual liability of high-ranking Saudis, including the Crown Prince, this very thing that we're talking about in this report. And you heard this new CNN report about these airplanes. The airplanes that the Saudi hit team traveled on have been, they're from this company that was seized by MBS less than a year before the murder. What conclusions can you draw from that?
Look, in my report, I had already pointed that there was much circumstantial evidence pointing to the responsibility of the Crown Prince, including in terms of ordering the crime. That included the fact that the killing of Jamal Khashoggi was clearly well-resourced by the state. It was premeditated. It was well-organized. The Crown Prince right-hand man, Saud al-Qahtani, met the killing team before it left. We now have further evidence that the private jet that carried members of the team, some of whom traveled under diplomatic passport, by the way, one of the private jets had diplomatic clearance indeed, that those were directly owned by the Crown Prince. So all of that point clearly to not only the fact that it was a state killing, but that it was a killing orchestrated and planned at the highest level of the state by the Crown Prince.
In your report, you say that the international response really to all of this, condemnations, sanctions, that has been insufficient. Do you expect, have you seen that improve, and do you expect that is going to change with this U.S. report coming out?
Yes, justice for Jamal is not an outcome. It's going to be a journey, and we have been on that journey for more than 2 years, including CNN, including international media, because you guys have kept the issue on the spotlight. So justice continues. Tomorrow, hopefully, because it was not today, our journey for justice will mark a new benchmark, which is a very important element in identifying with much more evidence the individual liability, the individual responsibilities of the Crown Prince. It's part of it. The next step is, what do we do with this information once we have clear evidence that the Crown Prince was implicated? Clearly, the U.S. is going to be put under a lot of pressure to take actions on the basis of that evidence, and it cannot just be business as usual. In my opinion, what it means is that now we have sufficient evidence to target the Crown Prince for individualized sanction. Targeting his asset abroad, that's a minimum that can be done in the spirit of the Magnitsky sanctions. Secondly, I believe that the Crown Prince has proven that he is not fit for the diplomatic circles, for the diplomatic arena, and that he should be banished for a number of those international meetings. That, to me, are really minimum steps that can be taken to punish the individuals. And in addition, I do hope that the U.S. administration is going to seize on that opportunity, quotation mark, to say, now, let's put in place the international and the national instruments that are going to protect journalists the world over. Because you know, as well as I do, that there are dozens of journalists who every year are killed, who do not receive the same degree of attention as Jamal. We now have the opportunity to push for far more effective instruments to protect them and to prevent targeted killings.